seems like most of us furries have a hard time fitting in and socializing. I mean, duh, that's obviously one of the requirements for being a furry, but it also extends into our enjoyment in the fandom itself, and that makes things a little bit difficult. So today, let's have a look at how you can actually make meaningful friends and socialize and have normal human interaction, because clearly, I'm the best role model for that. So, obviously, in a fandom like this, it's very likely that your first interaction with furries will be online, and that can go one of quite a few different ways. For instance, you can fall into the trap of acting the exact same way as everybody else, just trying to fit in.
Hello, what's this? Another cute fursuiter?
Jesus, holy fuck, let's never do anything that basic again. Why did I let you put that in the video? But yes, going in like that isn't exactly going to make you stand out. There's a million fuckers out there, just as my unread inbox on Instagram will tell you. So you want to actually be a bit more comfortable with who you are and exactly what you're trying to get across. Have a purpose to the reason why you're actually talking to somebody. Have an intention. Just make sure those intentions match up with the other person, for fuck's sake. You see, none of this shit will work out very well for you, will it? So, how do you go about speaking to people online? Right, well, this might sound like a little bit of a secret, but stay with me. You actually talk to them. Crazy, right? Isn't that fucking weird? But hear me out. If you're in a group chat, then strike up a conversation. If there's already one going, then join into it naturally. If you share interests with some people, then talk about them, you know, if they are, obviously if those interests allude, don't just bring them up at any fucking occasion. Observe the social cues and stick to them. It's not the hardest thing in the world. Well, at least I thought that, and then here we are. Don't try too hard to be something that you're not. Just be who you are, act how you act, and the right people will come into your life. It sounds pretty simple, right? Right? Ugh. Well, that's the online stuff covered up nicely like a respectful stripper on a Sunday morning in church, but what about the in-person interactions? Going to fur meets is one of the most important and intrinsic parts to the furry experience, and it can go amazingly well and catastrophically bad, sometimes both at the same time. First off, you're going to be very energetic and excited. You're going to want to fit in and interact with as many people as possible, but that can have its downfalls, and you need to make sure that you keep yourself restrained.
And then I said, vote for Brexit, I'd rather hug a mursuiter, Karen.
Right? Fuck you, Karen. I'd rather lick my own prolapsed anus.
See, that is just not the right way to act. A quick tip, never try and be the funniest person in the room. If it's gonna happen, it will happen naturally. And much like a priest's penis at a christening, if you try and force it where it doesn't belong, it's just gonna start a shitstorm. Of course, what you really want to do is find a point in the conversation where you can just merge in naturally and join in. And you'll find that people at a fur meet are pretty welcoming and accepting, and they're ready for things such as this. In fact, they might even be thankful.
Yeah, I just tend to find this time of year that the floors in my apartment are just so cold and hard. Like, I don't really want to walk on them. Like, I'm thinking of getting some slippers, but I just don't know what to go for.
Well, hello. I hear you need something soft, cute and fluffy underneath your feet, and unlike most of these perverted freaks in here, I don't mean myself.
Yeah, I was just saying, like, it's really cold in my apartment. I could really do with getting some slippers, but I don't really know where to go to get some decent ones, so...
Ah, my poor, cold little child. Come. We have much to discuss.
Now, I'm not saying that you should jump into any conversation that potentially mentions slippers. Or maybe I am. Maybe that is what I'm saying. No, obviously not. No. You need to find a logical point where you can join into the conversation and contribute to it and actually have, you know, a purpose. And then as you're talking with the other people, you can start to figure out whether they're people you can actually make a connection with and actually get on with. And trust me, that is something you really want to make sure you've done. Of course, course, there are certain cluster bombs of fucking hell, what the shit is this, that you should be aware of when traversing the minefield of human interaction. Not every situation is going to be so clear-cut and easy to navigate, and there are some things you should be wary of. Try not to alter yourself just to fit in. It never fucking goes well, it never lasts, and more worryingly, you might end up actually forcing yourself to fit in with people that you just don't mix well with. And that can really end nastily, okay?
Thanks guys, this is damn good.
Hello, I'm Artemis.
Oh, hello Artemis, I'm Alan. We're having some tea at the moment. Do you want some?
Oh yes, please, I love tea.
Excellent, I'll just get you a cup.
Thank you.
Oh, fuck. This disgusting, pissy weed water makes me choke every time I have to drink it. I just said how much I like tea, and if I don't, I'm gonna look like a fucking idiot. Jesus, here we go.
What you say? That you only meant well, of course you did. What you say? That it's all for the best, of course it is.
See what I mean? Sometimes that shit will just get rough, and I'm not just talking about the fact that I'm reusing that joke that I made months ago. See, fitting in with people that you really shouldn't will just blow up in your face like your dad on your... What? Oh, I'm sorry, I'm being told that last joke was a bit too far. There are a myriad of social situations you should be careful of, but I honestly don't have the time to go through each one of them with a humorous anecdote, so I'm gonna make it brief. Be careful of wanting something too much. If you're desperate to be friends with absolutely everybody, then you're gonna end up twisting and contorting yourself to fit in with whatever they desire, and you can only do that for so long. When you can't do it anymore, boom! Don't look at everyone through rose-colored glasses, because, the red flags are all there, but they just look like flags, and yes, that is a BoJack quote that I've used before, but fuck, it really fits. It really does well. Calm the fuck down. There's no reason to be rushing into everything. It's a marathon, not a sprint. You don't need to run right to the front and be friends with literally everybody. We get it. You might feel like you need to make up for lost time. It's okay. Just go with the flow, see how things go, and at the end of the day, it's never going to go exactly how you plan it in your head anyway. It's usually going to work out better than that, at least most of the time. Just slow the fuck down, okay? So there we go, there's some helpful tips on how to socialize and make friends. I will point out that I do not offer any guarantees or warranties with these tips. If it all goes tits up and blows up in your face, then that's your fault and your problem. I fully absolve myself of all guilt and responsibility. But I'm sure it won't. I'm sure it will go fine. I'm sure you'll learn your lesson and you'll figure out how to actually speak to people. Or at least I fucking hope you do. Jesus.